Hey folks, Big Deano here again, and welcome to my review of the Bandai Star Wars model kit, Capain Phasma. Now, before I get into this, I want to apologise. I have not been able to do any reviews for a while. Working full time and overtime and such will do that to you. but I am back now. And I've got some stuff to show your faces anyway. So, back to Phasma. Because the box is so massive, I have to have it out of frame. These boxes are always massive. Oh, you can just about make me out. Hello. So 1/12 scale, Capain Phasma, Bandai. You have Force Awakens on there. Nice picture of Phasma there. The Star Wars logo, just about there. We've got a nice big picture of Phasma there as well. And same on the sides and on the bottom. You've just got some generic poses and pictures. So yeah, let's get that out of the way and bring Phasma back in. Now, this one I was excited for originally, and it's still a decent one. It's still a decent figure, but it lacks the figuarts fluidity, if you know what I mean. You can't really get the model kit into female sort of poses, which is sort of what Phasma's made for. She's a female figure. But yeah, let's sit Phasma to this side here while we look at her accessories. She comes with a set of open hands. You will notice I have painted them. The black parts aren't black in the package. They are all silver. You have to do them yourself. I just got cheap modeler's acrylic and painted over it. It'll probably scratch back off right enough, but hey, I'm not going to be doing anything remotely stressful to it. So you get a pair of fist hands. Again, I painted them. And you get two trigger finger slash pose sort of hands. With a square hole for the gun. Speaking of the gun, get out. There we go. I'll leave the hand on there. the gun as well. You will realise quite quickly that, yeah, Captain Phasma's gun wasn't chrome. It was like an off gold colour, which the figuarts did really nicely. This one, they just done it in the same chrome that the figure was moulded out of, which I suppose is fair enough. They would need to use a brand new tree and new plastics just for a couple of wee pieces. As you can see, again, I've painted it rather sloppily, to be honest with you. It was just one quick coat. But yeah, it comes completely chrome in the package. You'll see on her, she has what they laughably call a cloth cape. Cloth. And she also comes with this thing, which, yeah, guys, you really could have came up with something better. And I know it's hard plastic. You're going to struggle to get something that would wrap around a figure. But seriously, I mean, you could have just had this piece continue all the way down on one bit. And that would have been the end of it. This does nothing. They've laughably put it in a ball joint, so it can swivel and move about. But, I mean, come on. Are you really going to pose your Captain Phasma in any other pose than standing straight with this thing on? I mean, it's rock solid plastic. There's no moving it at all. Why they thought that was a good idea, I have no idea. But yeah, the red is a sticker. A sticker that holds really well. It's actually, at first glance, I thought it was fabric that they put on it. It might just be textured paper, but I'm really not sure. But yeah, this thing is never going on her, honestly. So, off it goes. Getting into Phasma herself. Oh, almost forgot the cloth cape. Yeah, this thing, as you can see right through it. It really doesn't sit well at all. In fact, who was it? Fush, I believe, called it flag because it it sort of just sits there. The one good thing about it is, as you've seen at the start of the video, you can sort of work the fabric to give it a sort of flowing look without needing any sort of wires or anything like that, which is possibly partly why Bandai went with that. I mean, obviously it's the cheapest semi-paper fabric that they could get their hands on, but yeah. It does the job, I suppose. If you've got it in any sort of pose, then you're never going to notice. In fact, you know what kind of fabric this reminds me of? The Lego capes. It just came to my mind there. Yep, definitely, Lego capes. As for how you put it on, it's literally... Yeah, I'm not going to take them all off, but instead of having a hole, they have you pop it onto the neck peg in order to keep it on there, which is a strange choice, I'll be honest. I would have expected just a hole, but hey-o. I suppose it gets the flowing nature over the shoulder working quite well. But yeah, in terms of Phasma herself, I need to get back in the swing of this, I keep putting it too close to the camera. in terms of the details, she's very well done, being a model kit. Oh, you can see me in the camera again. That chrome though. but yeah, the chrome is very, very shiny. Possibly too much, I would say. Yeah, because Phasma, she wasn't quite chrome, but she wasn't quite the dull metal that the figuarts had. Hopefully the Mafex will finally solve that and we'll get a good in-between. But this does as a good, if nothing else, a good armour display, I suppose. But yeah, in terms of articulation, you've got the neck, which because of how this has moved, the cape moves with it. You've got a little bit down, a little bit up. It's really kind of limited in that respect. You've got a butterfly joint, which pulls that forward really well. As you can see, it's a ball joint in there. It can go up really far. This is on a separate piece. You can push that all back. Now, you notice it's really limited compared to the First Order Stormtrooper model kit. Especially when this is supposed to be a female figure, it doesn't sit flush against the body. You have to really pull out the ball joint in order to do it. But anyway, you've got the swivel at the shoulder. You've got double jointed elbow. I'll pull that out just now to show you. You can get that far. As with most of the model kits though, you can pull it out a little bit and get even more, which is handy. The Phasma one tends to be quite easy to pop out. I don't know if that's because of all the chrome being quite slippery by nature. But anyway, does the job. Nowhere near as much range in the abs and the waist. You've basically just got a swivel at the waist and the abs go down that far. They go up that far, but they've got a gap. Now, the legs are even worse, because pushed in, they're stuck in this wide-angle pose, which not even the First Order Stormtrooper had an issue with. But yeah, you've got the old-style figuarts, pull-down hips. You can get it probably to about there. Focus. All that chrome's affecting it. And you've got double-jointed knee, which is really restricted, actually. But you can, for the first time, actually do the same as the elbows and get a bit more range. But of course, you get a really large gap in there, which is a bit annoying. It does pop straight back in. And the feet are just the generic hinge and swivel. You get decent range with them, I suppose. But yeah. Let's take a quick look. Yeah, really, really chrome. But yeah, guys, would I recommend this Phasma over the figuarts? Well, normally I would actually be hesitant to say yes or no, because the model kits, focus, thank you, the model kits do have a certain, a certain benefit to them, I suppose, in terms of how cheap they are. But Phasma wasn't actually that much cheaper than the figuarts, at least when it first came out. The price I got this guy for was actually 30, which is, we're getting into expensive here. That's probably because of the overall height compared to all the other ones, because she has to be like 7 foot tall and all the chrome. But still, I don't know, if you can still get the figuarts and you don't mind the lack of chrome, then probably go with that one instead, because you'll get much more fluid stances out of it. But yeah, guys, that'll about do it for this video. So until next time, I'll see y'all later.